So first, I would like to thank Professor Zabaras and Zhiwen for the invitation. This is the fifth time I visited Hong Kong. Somehow, I always have some negative feeling about Hong Kong, except when I'm here. I change my mind every time, except the first time I when I lost all my money to Professor Wang Yang in a poker game. So today I'll talk about SDE method for solving nonlinear filter problems. Okay, so here is the problem setup. So suppose we have a dynamic system, without noise, just a regular autonomous SDE, right? But with noise perturbation, become SDE. And so then we have an observation of this system, because no matter how accurate your method is, this is SDE, right? Your solution is always a stochastic process. There are uncertainty in the process. So we try to understand the system better. What we do is to make observation on the system, okay? Not SD itself normally, but a function, a nonlinear function of the system, okay? So then we get the information, okay? How to characterize the information from a process? We do a sigma algebra, so to speak, right? So for if you have one random variable, the sigma algebra generated by that random variable is the information contained in that random variable. Okay, but with the process, we just use the sigma algebra generated by the process between 0 and t, for example. Okay, so this is the information we have. So what do you do about filter? We try to find the best estimate of the system, a function of the system, given this information. Okay, so this is called a conditional expectation, as the first speaker talked about. Okay, so this is really a projection. Okay, from a bigger L2 space to a smaller L2 space. Okay, so the result is still a process. So this is the nonlinear filter problem. Okay, so IFT is in Chinese translation is called stream of information. Right, so with the stream of information, we try to better understand the system itself. Okay, so in other words, we try to reduce noise, right? So the filtration, we try to filter noises, right? Okay, so maybe at first the solution go up and down, right? Very noisy. Okay, but after this filter, that it's going to be smoother. Okay, because we have better understanding of the system. All right, so I gave a similar talk about a few years back in some UK meeting at North Carolina. One statistician asked and said, we always do discrete model. We don't care about continuous model. So why do you do continuous model? So I argue that, first of all, because of availability of the large data, right? With data coming not in days, but in minutes and seconds, okay? So if the data coming so densely, then the model can be considered as a continuous model. Okay, so that's one argument. This is just related to the theme of the conference. And also, my method is a so-called SDE model. It's closer to discrete model. Okay, so in that sense, my method is feasible to solve discrete models. And also, with a continuous model, I can do rigorous analysis. That's what I can do. Okay, so whenever I see partial filters and common filter, I get headache. Okay, but with continuous model, I can do some analysis. Okay, all right. So let's try to do a setup. Okay, we try to use differential equation to solve this problem. Right. Let's step back a little bit. Suppose we do not have information at all. There's no observation. Okay, I can still do estimation the system. Right. Suppose I have phi x t. Okay. I want to do best estimation. What I do, I use one number, one vector, for example. If I can use a constant to estimate this system, what do you call that? The expectation, right? So expectation is also a best estimation. You just use one number, okay? So how do we do it? Well, it's simple. First, we do a so-called risk representation, okay? Suppose we know density of xt, then I can do this representation, right? So in the image space, okay? So once I have a this should be rho, well, it's p, okay? So one time, but I do know that the p actually satisfies this so-called Frank-Plan equation, right? That this is the theory, the standard theory in SDE, okay? So if I solve this so-called Frank-Plan equation, then I can find best adaptation based on one number, okay? But what if I have more information? What if I have a bunch of opposition as process? Again, this is so-called continuous expectation, right? This is best estimation with the noise, with the process, okay? So there is also a similar formula. It's called the Kalman formula that can represent this best estimation, continuous expectation, with another density function, okay? But this time, we call this continuous density function, okay? But this one is no longer a function. It's no longer deterministic, okay? It's going to be a random process. You know, imagine if it is deterministic, then the whole thing is deterministic. But that's wrong, right? Because the continuous expectation is random, okay? But it turns out that the P, this continuous expectation, also satisfy a differential equation. But this time, it's a stochastic differential equation. So this part, again, but imagine without this part, that's just Frank-Plan equation, right? So with this part, it becomes stochastic. But what's YT? YT is precisely my observation process. Okay, of course, it's not a Gaussian, it's not a Wiener process yet. But if I do a so-called Gerson transform, it can be a Wiener process. So then this is a standard stochastic partial differential equation. Okay, this is a Cao equation, and it's derived a long time ago, about more than 50 years ago. Okay, 1965 by Zakhar. So you can see that as long as I can solve this Zakhar equation, and I solve the problem. This problem is solved. So what's the problem? Well, the problem is it's very difficult to solve this SPDE. Okay, first of all, of course, this is a Wiener process. So as a result, the solution is going to have very low regularity. Okay, because the noise is not smooth. Okay, the bigger problem is high dimensionality. Okay, so you know, if you treat this as a PDE, okay, a physical PDE, then I have to be just in R1, R2, R3, right? So that's no problem. But this is a signal process, right? P is just the dimension is same as the dimension X, which can be hundreds and millions if you do a weather forecast, for example. Okay, so then it's not possible to solve this as PDE. You can forget about it. Okay, so. You know, in the engineering and in applications, we do not use SPDE, but Zakhar equation to resolve any filter problem. It's just too complicated, too difficult. Okay, so what we try to do is we try to find an alternative. Okay, we still want to use a continuous model, but not SPDE. But somehow we want to use SDE, but backward. That's the idea. Okay, this is actually a. Was done about 25 years ago by Peng and Purdue. Okay, they show that a nonlinear for SPD, even nonlinear. Okay, you can convert this to so-called a backward, forward, backwards SDE. Okay, this is so-called backward SDE. The backward SDE is very different from backwards. ODEs, okay, in the sense that there are two unknowns, okay? It's based on the so-called the mathematical representation, okay? So this is the link, okay? You can solve, you can link BSDE to SPDE, right? Then, of course, SPDE, the Zakhar equation, is linked to a nonlinear filter problem, but we can also link the SPD, BSDE to nonlinear filter problem directly. So this is what I did with my former student, Bao. Okay? So we start with so-called the Feynman cost formula. Okay? So you see, without filtration, FT, again, it's just typical standard Feynman cost setup. Okay? So you can show that this UT will satisfy a differential equation, a BSDE. Okay? So this is your backward, okay? This is backward. This is really backward. You see, look at this part. This is backward, okay? So in other words, at the terminal, initial time, there's no information anymore. Okay, the largest information is at terminal time. Okay, so but we do not want to. This is not my solution yet. My solution will be without this condition, right? So we try to get rid of this part. So what I can do is just like the Feynman-Kahn's and the Kolmogorov backward and forward theory for SDEs, I can establish another equation, which is a conjugate, which is an adjoint of the Feynman-Kahn's formula equation. So this is so-called this kind of also Fock-Plancke equation, but in the BSD form. Okay, so I'm not going to talk about too much in detail, but what I can say that this system is forward SDE and backward SDE is equivalent to the Zaikov filter, so it can solve a nonlinear filter problem. Okay, so that's what I try to do. Okay, now if you look at this equation, okay, this YT is still the opposition process. Okay, so in that sense, this is like a forward. Okay, because the more information you gather, right, then the larger the filtration. Okay, so it's understandable in this equation. Okay, I have a forward Brownian motion here. Okay, but this part, okay, this part is from the so-called the backward SDE. Okay, so this information going backward. Okay, so even though I start from x zero. Okay, so at the terminal time t, this has become this information will be smallest. Okay, so this is still a forward backward SDE. Again, this is backward, right? Backward is forward. Okay, now forward backward is backward. Okay, and forward is still forward. Okay, again, I call this is a Fock-Plancke equation. I can use this. I can really use this to solve my problem, to solve the filtration nonlinear filtering problem. So I think I'll finish very quick. Now, what's the advantage of doing this? Well, like I said, unlike Zaikov filter, it's SPD. I do not want to solve SPD. Okay, I want to solve SDEs, even though it's backward. Okay, and with this, I can do mesh free. Okay, if you solve SPDs, you must do mesh, right? Because it's PDE. Okay, so I do not have to use mesh at all. So this is, somehow you can call this a mesh-free filter. Okay, and also in my filter, I can use Monte Carlo method to do to find the expectations. I don't use the integral formulation. If you use integral formulation, then I have expectation in spatial dimension. Okay, so then I can in the spatial dimension, I can use Monte Carlo. Again, avoid mesh. Okay, it's a mesh-free method. I don't list here. If you do try to solve Zaikov equation, it's SPD, right? The higher-order method is almost impossible. But with this method, I can construct a higher-order method, just like an SDE. Okay, I can use Mielsen scheme, for example, to get a higher-order method. So that's why my goal. I want to solve this problem efficiently, more accurately than Zaikov equation. And for example, this is the first game we constructed. So what you do is just like solving SDEs. Okay, I can use the Ito-Taylor formula to approximate those terms. Okay, to get higher order method. This is one example. But the difference is that we have two Brownian motions, remember, forward and backward, right? So I need to use the so-called two-side Taylor, Ito-Taylor formula. So it involved both this opposition process, right? Which is a Wiener process under transform. And this is from the backwards SDEs, okay? So I get two Brownian motions, but I can still use two Taylor expansions, okay? This is somehow is a first order Taylor expansion, Ito-Taylor expansion. Okay, so with this, I can construct a Mielsen scheme like an algorithm. Okay, so I can show that this is first order convergence. Okay, so again, if you do a SPDs, it's almost impossible to construct the first order scheme. Recently, I also tried to use a so-called split out method. Okay. Remember, I have a in this equation. This is a so-called this is I got two Brownian motion involved here. Right? Two Wendel process involved. Okay. This is backward and forward. Okay. What I try to do is I want to split up. Okay. I want to this is called doubling. This is not really in theory. It's called backward doubly SDE. Doubly means that two Brownian motions. Okay, so I want to do split up. This is the idea of so-called split up scheme. So the first in the first step we call it prediction. Okay, so this is actually a backward. Let me see. Yeah, this is actually a forward SDE. Okay, so we try to solve this problem this is actually the update step. Okay, we try to solve SDE first. Then I did not mention that the z is really the Mulliman derivative when you try to use Monte Carlo representation to derive this is the differential equation. Okay, once I have that, then I can solve this backward SDE. So you see. In these two equations, I only have one Brownian motion on each equation. Okay, this is a split up method. And so I can also prove that this is a first order scheme. And with this split up, I can solve this problem even more efficiently. Okay, there are no two Brownian motion involved anymore. So this is very similar to the split scheme for the Zakhov equation. Okay, in Zakhov equation, you can also do split, right? You can split to determine PDE and SDE. Okay, so the backward SDE is like a determined PDE. Okay, and the forward SDE for just forward SDE. Okay, so with that formulation still continuous model. Okay, I still need to discretize those integrals. Okay, but once I have this integral formulation, then I can just use any standard schemes like a Mason scheme to construct the real first order scheme. Okay, so that's another error estimation. It's kind of a little confusing because it's somehow the split scheme is already discretized already, but it's not. Okay, this is just a simple numerical example to show that this is indeed a first order scheme. But somehow, if you look at it, this is my prediction. The prediction is not good enough yet. So in the first step, I try to solve the SDEs. But once I solve the BSDE, then I get first order scheme. And somehow, z is like a derivative, right? So somehow, supposedly, the z's order should be one half less. In our numerical experiments, we also get first order. So somehow this is a super convergent feature of our scheme. So we have yet to prove this. Okay, so here are some numerical experiments. So this is so-called multiple target tracking problem. Imagine there are just a group of airplanes flying on a mission. Okay, so they are coordinated. So as a result, of course, their trajectories satisfy the system differential equations, okay, with noise perturbation. Okay, then we can observe the latitude angle and the altitude angle and the distance. Okay, so this is my observation, like on the ground. Okay, so with this information, of course, we try to better estimate the trajectory of these airplanes. Okay, suppose they are enemy airplanes. So this is a real problem, a real world problem. Okay, in this example, we compare our method with the so-called party filter, which I didn't mention at all, which is, of course, it's one of the most popular nonlinear filter method in the last 20 years. Okay, so I have 10 targets here. So you can see that the black ones are just so-called the real solutions. Okay, you can see that here and here, the party filters are off target. Okay, I think also, the third one is another one off target also, okay, and this one. But if you look at our method, the BSD filter method, it's all on target. Okay, so it's a very accurate method. marker than part filter, at least. And also, you can see that this is the mean square errors. Okay, for part filters, there is general impression that is for long-term simulation is unstable. That means that the error becomes larger and larger. Okay, but we do not have this problem. You can see this is our error for the BSD filter. But this is for particles. Okay, for part filter, the error is going up at least linearly. But our method is quite stable. Okay, so that's the advantage of our method over the part filter method. Another example, as the first speaker talked about, is the Lorentz model. Okay, I can remember if it's 63 or some or what. If we choose those parameters, okay, this way then. Is chaotic, okay? Well, this is the precise picture you showed in your talk, okay? So there are some two attractors go back and forth. It's a highly unstable system, okay? It's well known that if you use power filter, it just doesn't work, okay? You cannot simulate the system. What do you do? You can use a Zaka filter or our filter, okay? This showed the errors, okay? The mean square errors. Okay, you can see that. This is the communal time. Okay, so I can see that for the same error, our method consume little time compared to Zaka filter. Like I said, Zaka filter is very costly, right? It's just almost impossible for practical application. This is somehow one example. Okay, am I finished in 10 minutes? Okay, what I showed just is a new part filter method. I think my filter is almost like a bridge between the Zaka filter, which has, you have to solve SPDE, right? All part filter, there's no differential equation at all. Okay, I can. My method, of course, in analysis is the same, is equivalent to Zaka filter, SPD, but I can use all kinds of different methods to solve it, match-free, high-order method, okay? On the other hand, I can also use the part filter ideas, like a square root Monte Carlos, to do my discretization, okay? So I feel like this is the bridge between discrete filter, part filter, current filter, and the continuous filter, like Zaka filter. Okay, and recently I read some papers for V9E and honor for Jensen. Okay, they have so-called they use the deep neural network to solve BSD, the backward as SDEs without doubling, right? But if I split up, if I use split method, then I can split the so-called backward double SDE to a forward SDE and backward SDE with one quantum motion. So then I can use their method to solve this problem. Okay, this is somewhat related to the theme of this conference. Okay, but my idea is that I really want to see if my method can help to solve some big data problem. Okay, AI problem. This is the cliche about ask not be that big data and the AI can do for me. Ask what I can do for big data and the AI. That's my talk. Thank you. Yeah, just let me see. It's just artificial noise, just very simple, just artificial. Yeah.
And do you study like zero noise limits?
No.